Simon Says subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive notifications.
In this section of the course, we're going to be discussing a very important topic in Excel, and that is how we can find duplicates within our data. And when it comes to finding duplicates, there are numerous different methods that we can use. So in this first lesson, I'm just going to show you a couple of tricks that you can use to find duplicates using conditional formatting. So if we take a look at this first data set, you can see that we have two lists of names. And the first list are all of the people that attended webinar 1 and all of the people that attended webinar 2. So maybe this is some kind of training presentation that's been split across two webinars, and staff members are required to attend both webinars. So we've taken the attendance lists of both of these webinars, and now we want to compare the two lists to find out who didn't attend both of the webinars, because we need to send those people an email. Now, we can do this very simply using conditional formatting. So what we're going to do here is we're going to select the first row, Control Shift down arrow to select both of the lists. On the Home tab, we're going to go to Conditional Formatting, highlight Cell Rules, and notice at the bottom here we have an option for duplicate values. So if we click on this, we get this little window pop up, and currently it's highlighting all of the duplicates with a light red fill and dark red text. Now, of course, you can click the drop down and you can change this to something else. So yellow fill, green fill, light red fill, or you can even choose your own custom format if you want to. So let's go with the green fill. Now, what I'm seeing here are all of the duplicate names. So when we have duplicate names, these people currently showing in green attended both of the webinars because they exist in both lists. So if I wanted to compose a big long list of everybody who attended, this would be a great way to do that. We can highlight those names. But what if I want to find out who didn't attend both of the webinars? Well, this is where we can click the drop down and we can choose unique. Now, when we click on OK, I can see who doesn't exist in both lists. So the names that we have underneath webinar 1, these people are not in the webinar 2 list, and the names highlighted in green in the webinar 2 list don't exist in the webinar 1 list. So now this makes it really easy for me to know who I need to send emails to. And if I want to get this formatting into more of a logical order, I can click at the top here and I could add some filters to the top of the columns. And then what we can do is click the drop down. We can say filter by color, filter by cell color, and choose the green. And it's only going to show me the people who didn't attend webinar 2. I would then need to go in and do the same for this list. So we can go to filter by color. We're going to select green. And we need to remember to clear this filter, and then we're going to see who didn't attend webinar 1. So that is the first method that you could use. Now we do have another method, which is better when you're comparing rows. And this isn't necessarily conditional formatting, but I've decided to include it in this lesson anyway because it's really, really quick. So you can see here we have again two lists of data, serial number 1 and serial number 2. And what I want to do is I want to check to see if the value in the serial number 1 column is the same as the value in serial number 2. So we're effectively seeing if there are any row differences. So if we need to do that and compare things across rows, we can simply select our data set, press Ctrl G to jump into the Go To dialog box, and we want to go into Go To Special. Now we have an option in here called Row Differences. So when I select that and click on OK, you can see it's going to highlight in the table where there are differences in these rows. So it's highlighted the second one down. And when I say highlighted, it's actually not highlighting them, it's just selecting them. But it's telling me that this serial number in the second row is different to its counterpart in the first row, and the same for the bottom two. And I can see that, yes, if we take a look at this second one, in the first column, it's 8890. In the second column, it's 8850. So maybe somebody's made a typo error just there. So that little option is perfect if you just want to find out if there are differences between rows. Have a little practice of these. They are super useful, and I will see you in the next lesson. In this quick lesson, I'm going to show you another method that you can use when it comes to finding duplicates across different lists. And this time we're going to be using formulas. Now, much like the last lesson, we have two lists of people who attended webinars. But this time I want to find out who did attend both webinars, because I want to send them a follow-up email. Now, I know that we had some no-shows, so I just want to compare both of these lists together and just get a big long list of everybody who went to both Webinar 1 and Webinar 2. Now, we can do this using the filter function, which is a reasonably new function in Excel, and count if. So let's click in cell D6. We're going to type in equals, and we're going to type filter. So our array. Now for this example, we just want to select the first column as our array. Control shift down arrow, and I'm going to press F4 to lock those cells. Comma. And the second argument include, this is where we want to do our count if. So if we type in count if, our range is going to be all of the participants in the second list. F4 to lock, and our criteria is going to be everybody in the first list again. Control shift down arrow and F4 to lock. So what we're doing here is we're basically counting the participants who attended webinar 2 against webinar 1, and then the filter allows us to extract the names as opposed to a count of the values. So let's close off our count if, close off our filtered, hit enter, and that gives us a list of all of the people who attended both webinars. So I can now safely send an email out to these people following up on the webinars. And this is going to give me a list of all of the people who attended both webinar 1 and webinar 2, so I know who to send my email to. So don't forget that aside from conditional formatting to find duplicates, aside from using that row differences option in GoToSpecial, we can also compare lists together using the filter and COUNTIF functions. Now, we just did this on two columns. You could modify this and do it on more columns. So maybe you've got three columns, four columns, five columns that you want to compare together. It's time now to do exercise 6. And in this exercise, we're going to practice some of the skills that we've learnt in this section of the course. And in this section, we were taking a look at how we can find duplicates. So this is a fairly straightforward exercise. You can see in column B, we have a list of countries. And in column C, we have another list of countries. Now, what I'd like you to do is in column D, in the result column, I'd like you to add a formula that compares the country list in column B with the country list in column C. So I'd like you to find which countries appear in both lists. So think about the formula that you need in order to achieve this. And if you'd like to see my solution to this exercise, then download the exercise 6 solution file from the exercise files folder. Good luck with that, and I will see you in the next section.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.